Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammah, I magnify your name because you are the one and only. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammah, I lift your name above every other name because there is no God like you. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammah, I exalt your name because you are the one and only. You are the I am that I am. You are the God of the heavens. You are the God of the whole earth. You are the kings of the heavens. You are the kings of the whole earth. You are the prince of the nations. You are the kings of kings, the gods of gods, the lords of lords. You are the sovereign Lord, the God that can do all things, the God of all flesh, the spirit of all prophets. I worship you because you are the righteous judge. I worship you because you are the only God. All the other gods are the works of men. They are the gods of bronze. They are the God of iron. They are the God of metal. You are alone. You are the living God. You are the active God. You are the creator. You are the maker. You are the ruler of all things. You are the faithful God. The God that created the heavens and the earth. The God that created all living and non-living things. The God that created the oceans and caused its waves to roar. The God that created the lions. The God that created the elephant. Yet you are the God that created the termites and the ants. I worship you today because you are the deliverer. You are the savior. You are the healer. I worship you because you are the holy God. You are the God of all comfort. You are the gracious God. You are the God that can do all things. Let your name be praised. Let your name be magnified. Let your name be exalted. Let your name be lifted above every other name. Let your name be exalted and be promoted above every other name. This is Save the World, a Christian ministry with a divine mandate to set the captives free and give sight to the blind by the power in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My name is Baba Tokpe Babanobi. By the grace of God and the leading of the Spirit, I'm sharing a message which is titled The Rod of Moses. The Rod of Moses. The Rod of Moses is one of the weapons of spiritual warfare. The rod of Moses is one of the weapons of warfare against the force of darkness. And in this message, we shall be looking at what is the rod of Moses. What can we do with the rod of Moses? What can we achieve with the rod of Moses? And the reference text for this message is taken from Exodus chapter 9, verse 23. It says, "And Moses stretched forth his rod toward heaven, and the north sent thunder and hail, and the fire ran along the ground, and the north rained hail upon the land of Egypt." I take that again, Exodus chapter 9, verse 23. "And Moses stretched forth his rod toward heaven, and the north sent thunder and hail, and the fire ran along the ground, and the north rained hail upon the land of Egypt." We saw in the book of Exodus that God did a lot of miracles through the rod of Moses. We saw in the book of Exodus that God delivered the Israelites from bondages through the rod of Moses. We saw in the book of Exodus that God disgraced Pharaohs and the Egyptians through the rod of Moses. We saw in the book of Exodus that God confounded the magicians and the oppressors of the Israelites through the rod of Moses. I'm persuaded that there is another rod of Moses that God has given you. The word of God is a rod of Moses for you. Your hand is a rod of Moses. You may not have the physical rod of Moses with you, but the word of God with you is the rod of Moses. Your hand is the rod of Moses. And today, that same miracle, that same supernatural miracle that God did through the rod of Moses, God shall do it through the spiritual rod of Moses that we are holding in form of the Bible in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The rod of Moses can bring forth deliverance. The rod of Moses can bring forth supernatural miracles. The rod of Moses can disgrace and put to shame your enemies. The rod of Moses can disgrace those who are boasting against your God. And today, as you strengthen your hands forward, I command it to turn to the rod of Moses. Be turned to the rod of Moses. Be turned to the rod of Moses in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As you stretch forth your hand, I decree that the power and the might, the anointing of the rod of Moses shall fall upon your hands. It shall fall upon your hands. Let it fall upon your hands in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The power to confound your accusers, the power to disgrace your persecutors, let it fall upon you. Let it fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. There is a rod of Moses that God uses to do miracles. Today I provoke that same rod of Moses to speak for you. The rod of Moses shall speak for you. you. The rod of Moses shall deliver you. The rod of Moses shall make a way for you when there is no way. The rod of Moses shall disgrace your enemies. The rod of Moses shall fight for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. With the rod of Moses, God confounded the magicians of Egypt. By that same rod of Moses, let your persecutors, every enchanter, every sorcerer that is gathered against you, let them be confounded, let them be disgraced, let them be disgraced, let them be disgraced in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When Moses stretched the rod into the heavens, God released thunder, God released air, and God released fire. Today, as you stretch your hands towards heaven, let the thunder of God fall upon your persecutors, let the thunder of God fall upon your accusers, let the thunder of God fall upon every evil conspirators that gather against you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As you stretch your hands towards heaven, I provoke the thunder of God over every stronghold of darkness that is gathered against you. Let them be uprooted, let them be uprooted, let them be smashed into pieces in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When Moses stretched his rod towards heaven, hail fall from heaven. Today, I release the hand of God over every evil gathering, over every witchcraft gathering. Those who have gathered against you at night, the Bible says that surely they shall gather, but not by me. As many powers of darkness, as many dark powers, as many principalities and powers, as many spiritual forces of darkness that are gathered against you, let them be scattered by the rod of Moses. Let them be scattered by the rod of Moses. Let them be scattered by the rod of Moses in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When the rod of Moses was stretched towards heaven, fire fell from heaven. Today, let the fire of God, the devouring fire of God, the consuming fire of God, let the fire of the God of Elijah, let it fall upon you, let it give you anointing, let it strengthen you, let it envelop you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When the rod of Moses was stretched towards heaven, fire fell from heaven. Today, let the fire of God fall upon your evil conspirators, let them be roasted by fire, let them be roasted by fire, let them be burned into ashes in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. By the rod of Moses, the Red Sea parted. Today, I speak to your Red Sea. Every block, every hindrances, every Red Sea of marital delay, every Red Sea of barrenness, every Red Sea of marital disappointment, every Red Sea of stagnancy, every Red Sea of business failure, every Red Sea of rejection, every Red Sea of disappointment, every Red Sea of sicknesses and diseases, every Red Sea of sudden death, I command it to be parted. Let them be parted. Let them be parted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When the rod of Moses was stretched toward the Red Sea, the Pharaohs and the Egyptians, the odd pursuers of the Israelites were consumed by the Red Sea. Today, I stretch the rod of Moses towards every Red Sea, and I command every Pharaoh, let their horses, let their chariots, let them be consumed, let them be consumed, let them be perished, let them perish, let them perish. Let your hot pursuers, let every herald, let every Pharaoh that is pursuing your destiny, let them be consumed by the Red Sea, let them be consumed by the Red Sea, let them be consumed by the Red Sea, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When the rod of Moses was stretched toward the Red Sea, the Red Sea opened his mouth and swallowed the enemies of Moses and the Israelites. Today, I spread the rod of Moses in the Red Sea, and I command every of your challenge, every of your difficulties, every sicknesses, every difficulty, every mountain before you, all the horses and the chariots that are pursuing your destiny, all the Pharaoh and the oppressive spirit pursuing your destiny, let them be consumed by the Red Sea, let them be swallowed by the Red Sea, let them be swallowed by the Red Sea, be swallowed by the Red Sea, be swallowed by the Red Sea, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I strike the rod of Moses into the way where there's no way for you, let there be a way. I strike the rod of Moses onto your jobs, onto your businesses, where your businesses is failing, let it start to succeed. I strike the rod of Moses into your womb, and I decree you shall be a mother of children. I strike the rod of Moses onto your brain. I decree that where you have been failing before, you shall start to succeed. I strike the rod of Moses into your certificates, and I decree that every satanic embargo shall be broken. They shall be broken in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you today that the rod of Moses shall fight for you. The rod of Moses shall make a way for you. The rod of Moses shall deliver you. The rod of Moses shall speak for you. The rod of Moses shall cause you to be favored. The rod of Moses shall cause you to be appointed. The rod of Moses shall fight your battles in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is well with you. I cover you with the blood of Jesus Christ. Life is a portion. You shall never not die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, I am persuaded that before the rod of Moses shall work for you, you have to be a child of the living living God. Is there anything in your life? Is your walk not straight with God? You have the opportunity today to say yes to Jesus Christ and right here where you are. If you can believe in your heart, you know Jesus, and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, you shall be saved. And today, I want you to say this simple prayer after me. Jesus Christ, I come to you as I am. I confess I'm a sinner. I accept you into my life. Let your blood wash my sins away. Holy Spirit, I invite you to my life. I am born again in Jesus' mighty name. If you accept that prayer, you are now a child of God, and I'm persuaded that God shall fight for you. With the rod of Moses, God shall give a breakthrough. With the rod of Moses, your heaven shall be opened. With the rod of Moses, every blockages shall be destroyed. With the rod of Moses, every hindrance shall be smashed to pieces in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When the rod of Moses was stretched to the heavens, fire, hail, and thunder fell from God. With the thunder, fire, and hail of God, every of your challenges shall be consumed. They shall fade away. They shall fade away. You shall see them no more. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This message is coming to you from Save the World, a Christian ministry with a divine mandate to set the captives free and give sight to the blind, but by the power in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My name is Baba Tokwe Babanubi. For more information on how you can work with God for prayers and counseling, the phone number to call is +234 8035 897435. It is well with you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.